Timesheet, Chapter 27, Part B. Verse 33. Yitzhak began trembling uncontrollably and said, "Then who was it that took game and brought it to me? I ate it all just before you came, and I gave my blessing to him. That's the truth, and the blessing must stand." When Esav heard his father's words, he burst into loud, bitter sobbing. "Father, bless me too," he begged. He replied, "Your brother came deceitfully and took away your blessing." Esav said, "His name, Yaakov, he supplants, really suits him, because he has supplanted me these two times. He took away my birthright, and here, now he has taken away my blessing." Then he asked, "Haven't you saved a blessing for me?" Yitzhak answered Esav, "Look, I have made him your lord. I have given him all his kinsmen as servants, and I have given him grain and wine to sustain him. What else is there that I can do for you, my son?" Esav said to his father, "Have you only one blessing, my father?" "Father, bless me too," Esav wept aloud. And Yitzhak, his father, answered him, "Here, your home will be of the richness of the earth and of the dew of heaven from above. You will live by your sword, and you will serve your brother, but when you break loose, you will shake his yoke off your neck." Esav hated his brother because of the blessing his father had given him. Esav said to himself, "The time for mourning my father will soon come, and then I will kill my brother Yaakov." But the words of Esav, her older son, were told to Rivkah. She sent for Yaakov, her younger son, and said to him, "Here, your brother Esav is comforting himself over you by planning to kill you. Therefore, my son, listen to me. Get up and escape to Laban, my brother in Haran. Stay with him a little while until your brother's anger subsides. Your brother's anger will turn away from you, and he will forget what you did to him. And I'll send and bring you back from there. Why should I lose both of you on the same day?" Rivkah said to Yitzhak, "I'm sick to death of Hitti women. If Yaakov marries one of the Hitti women, like those who live here, my life won't be worth living."